Angela. That's okay, my prediction.
Fun,
so
fun.
Exactly.
We'll
that's
see,
why.
We'll see, we'll
that's
see.
Why. Geek fan. I think it's all right. We already know where everyone's going for the side of Geek fan here. It is going to be Vince on the Matilda once more. Arashi, we didn't see a huge impact from this team in the first game. Why? Because no siege potential. It seems like they're going for the same exact draft, but with different heroes.
Well, right now they have a lot more heroes available to force fights when Aura is trying to buy time and scale into that late game. So with the Jawhead, with the Dairoth, Matilda still, they have a lot more chances to force the fights and get pickoffs under the turret and then translate that pickoff into objectives, and perhaps they can end the game before 15 minutes. But that is Aura's territory, man, so they need to play this perfectly.
They need to play this perfectly, as both lineups have already been secured. I'm curious what the viewers, what the audience think about this. Are you more in favor of Aura Fire, or are you more in favor with Geek? Because to be honest, I do favor Aura Fire a bit better, but it seems like Valentina is going to be in the gold lane, but we'll make sure as we're going straight into the portal for game number two between Aura Fire as well as
Geek. Hey, I was right.
Right.
Hey, I was right.
Yes, you are indeed. Well, hey. Kabuki on that Valentina though. Now that is scary.
Exactly. I feel like you want to give the playmaking heroes to the side of Kabuki most of the times, right? But if you have Hai on your team who's so flexible, Valentina could work. The main reason I didn't predict the Valentina to go to the jungle, Arashi and Eterna, is because Jamet, very shallow hero pool, like I mentioned. He's only played the Assassins and obviously the Pakito, but Kabuki's having a hard time in lane against Xuan.
Yeah, the Grok pick has been so strong right now. Hans is nearby, and with Kabuki being on half HP, the rest of the team will come to try and back him up. Aura is not to play around for the side lane, especially the gold lane, so so far, it's still pretty predictable, but in the mid lane,
Vince gets taken quite low here, but still will be able to get out of that with the ejector coming into play here. But Xuan now, 2v1 situation, he is able to flicker out, but Kabuki goes in with that flicker as well. A little aggressive, but and unfortunately was unable to get that kill.
Absolutely. You know, again, Geek fam will definitely have the early stage of the game controlled if they play it properly. Like, if they have this Dearoth, it's very hard to lose lane against it. I mean, lose lane in on this Dearoth. But Jamet is going in onto Renvi here. What?
Yeah, Renvi actually forced the flicker away from this one as Fluffy goes in as well. Renvi will be taken down with first blood. Unfortunately, Hans was a little late.
Whoa.
Yeah, what? The mobility and the ganking just comes in clutch for Aura. This is their territory, man. They're used to playing in the early game and using that fast rotation to catch members off guard and then get a lead in the side lanes. So already demonstrating how it should be done. And Geek fam, despite having the aggressive roster and actually having a lot more crowd control to make plays with, they have not found success.
One disadvantage when you are playing the Dearoth is that you're so easily ganked, and that's exactly what Aura Fire play for. They go play towards that top side, the pathing was perfect, and they use Facehugger on the Eve just to play as a utility support. As you can see, yeah, he deals some damage, but mostly he's just going to be the utility here. They have a lot of damage in the jungle, even in Valentina, who is in that gold lane. Renvi, I don't think you can go for this, man. It's not a wise move to go for the duel against Balmain when all he needs to do is cut those waves.
I think right now it's also a fact that like Aura Fire has a lot less crowd control. So will that be a deciding factor? Because it was in game number one for Geek fam, and right now the shoe is on the other foot. So we'll have to see. Aura has knows how to take advantage of the crowd control advantage, but do they know how to play when they don't have it? That will be something that they can demonstrate to us viewers and, you know, casters and viewers alike.
Uh-oh, but now Hans is going aggressively onto the members of Aura Fire. We'll still be able to retreat for now. It doesn't seem like they have too much in mind, but look at this, Circling Eagle onto Facehugger. Facehugger forced to retreat and will still be able to, denying that kill away from Geek fam.
Absolutely. Once again, it's Geek fam who is reactive, I feel like, right? The main reason they haven't been able to get the early game pressure in this game is because, guess what? Aura Fire have been the ones more proactive on the map. Kabuki got ganked earlier. We haven't seen aggressive movements from Geek fam, and that's not good. They're an early game composition. This is a full fire comp. If they make it to the mid game, oh man. Aura Fire is just going to have a lot of fun with their composition here.
Oh my god! Instant obliteration from the side of Aura Fire as he just gets melted down.
Wow.
And what initially we thought was the winning lane is actually now the losing lane here, Mirko.
Like we said, man, you always want to play for your winning lanes, but Geek Fam, they play for the bottom side of the map instead of that Dairoth who can snowball. Now that Fluffy has the lead against the Dairoth, he's going to be unkillable in that lane. And look, he's the one contesting the turtle, not Jomet, who's still off top.
He just comes in to rotate and pressure people away. Rupture is trying to make a play happen, though.
Yeah, Ejector connects onto Facehugger. Facehugger will be the target, will also be successfully taken down as Fluffy forces Flicker away from that as he is stuck in a 4v1 situation. And not much that Aura Fire can do with two members actually in different spots, as well as Facehugger taken down first.
This is where the decision-making from Aura Fire starts to get wonky. They got the turret gold up top. I feel like they should have just taken that trade. Turtle for turret gold, much more worth for the side of Aura Fire because they got a kill as well. But no, they wanted to force to get that neutral objective, even though they've already gotten a lot done in that top side because they overcommit, because they're doing way too many things. They lost that fight. Geek Fam have equalized.
He can have equalized, and again, in the early game, they have a lot more potential to make these aggressive plays. The draw had this, the setup coming in from their team can actually be so strong, but there's no real opportunity for the draw to gank. So right now, Rupture is having a hard time.
Yeah, this might actually be it. I mean, four members already dedicating all their resources in the bottom side, but Kabuki is actually still surviving with the help of Heartguard as well. So Geek Fam have allocated all their resources to the bottom, but still unable to get a trade on the board.
Full HP Kabuki bottom, low HP diveable Balmain up top, and they go for the bottom side. Heart guard instantly there. Kabuki is alive. You know, again, the winning lane, even after he goes 0-2-0, is still that top side. Renvi, he has kill pressure.
There you go. As we talk about kill pressure, instant burst down to Godiva. But again, he is still a roamer at the end of the day, and Hans goes toe-to-toe against Jomet.
Oh, what is Jomet doing here? He may be looking for a trade, perhaps, but Godiva, just, you know, let it go. I think Godiva is going to be a really good and juicy target for Geek Fam to pick off. So I'm not quite surprised that Godiva was taken down earlier, but what can Geek Fam do with that is the question. I don't see any response from Geek Fam, but it seems like they might be setting up for this turtle.
Maybe. Yep. There's one thing that, you know, Godiva can do right now.
What can he do?
Why isn't he... Oh, he is actually wearing... Look at that. The Sanrio skin. He's using the Hello Kitty skin on that Angela. So you guys can do that as well here. As that's still Hans. So on point with the turtle.
Still very on point with the turtle, as it is going to be an engage here. Aura Fire Face. It goes down first. Once again, two deaths already here in the sixth, almost seventh minute of the game. And Geek Fam, they're starting to, I guess, realize their priorities. They want to be taking out Facehugger first before they go in on the other targets.
Well, they really need to be careful here. And for Geek Fam, they just have to make sure they get a lot more pickoffs, because that is one really good play from Rupture, but that's not enough, you know? If they can get the plays going, they do have the damage to burst anybody down with their composition. But
oh
there
my
we go.
God, on top side, it is going to be Fluffy taken down just like that. And Geek Fam has actually been able to secure an objective on the board. That turret goes down into their pockets.
Where did the turret fall? Into that top side. Who's the winning lane? Top side. Jomet gets engaged on.
Jomet gets engaged on, but still manages to get out of that situation even though he is low. But now Kabuki going a little aggressive onto Vince, who still will be able to get out of there for now.
Kabuki play for NV and you get objectives, Arashi. That's the name of the game. And look, two turrets up top.
Yep. I feel like they could have done this way, way earlier.
Yeah.
Because of course, Fluffy doesn't want to back down, right? The XP lane is a lane that is usually left alone, so any kind of advantage will be so beneficial. And if they actually bank on the fact that like Renvi is stronger, they can actually gank him as well. But
No, Kabuki goes down next, and this is pushing Geek Fam more ahead than before, to be honest.
Yep, the instant burst coming in from Xuan, already securing a BOD as well. This is the power of that damage build Grok. Somewhat still tanky, but doing an insane amount of damage, especially to the squishier members. And right now, Renvi is able to clear the wave. Aura needs to wait for a bit longer. I'm not sure if this is the best play to be making. But as I was saying earlier, if they actually bank on the fact that Aura is going to try and shut down Renvi, they can match the gank and go 2v2 and still win those fights. So I think that was the play they should have been going for.
Man, that was a lot of time wasted there in the top side, as now Geek Fam, they're looking to take this Lord as well. Jamet won't let this go earlier. Look at that damage onto Vince. We'll be able to zone him out, but Fluffy in the top side, in the mid side, is doing quite a amount of damage as well, as the hard guard is onto Jamet right now. Let's see what they can do with this, as, oh my god, another member has been taken down. Schwan goes down first. Hunt might be the next target here, but he will be able to get that Paquito off the board before he goes down. And once again, trades happening all over the map. Renvi goes back in and will not be taken down just yet, but the Flicker comes into play here from the side of Fluffy, being able to take him down too. But who is next? But wow, what a game from the side of Aura Fire as well as Geek Fam, just trades after trades.
Man, Geek Fam, they had the Glee, but they still forced that Lord. Again, they could have just played the side lanes, wait for a good opportunity. Vince stepping in.
Oof, that's a lot. That is a very bold play by Vince. And honestly, he does a lot of damage only if there's a member left alone. When Aura Fire groups together, it's just a lot more difficult for the Matilda damage to come out as cleanly as we would expect. So now Aura trades 2 for 2, gets the Lord, and instantly uses it to try and get more objectives. Split push by Fluffy, and the rest of the team goes for that mid turret.
Yeah, it does seem like that is going to be the case, as the real-world manipulation has been opened up to zone the members of Geek Fam away to be able to take that turret in the mid-side. But so far, Aura Fire, they've been playing quite disciplined. They don't want to engage into something that is too hasty, as once again, they will be pushing from all the lanes. But look at this, a conceal play is opened up here. The Assault Force is and will be able to connect onto Jamet. Godiva barely makes it out alive, but still will be able to survive. But Jamet goes in and will not be able to take down anyone. And he is the one being chased away by Hans as well as Vince. Will he be able to escape right now? Fluffy, Kabuki, they're here, they're back. And will be able to back the members from the side of Aura Fire, allowing Jamet to survive to see another day.
That was insane by Jamet. The micro skills and the, I don't know, the composure that he showed.
Kabuki! He gets taken down with an amazing play coming in from Rupture.
What?
But what cost? Kabuki goes down, but Rupture as well. A one-for-one trade as of right now as Geek Fam. Man, they don't want to go down without a fight.
Oh my goodness gracious. There's just micro plays all over the map. Jamet using his passive properly to get out of there in the bottom side, and the Rupture instantly showing class. But unfortunately, they had to spend so many resources for Kabuki. Let's take a look at what just happened here. Rupture, wow!
That was a very, very fast ejector, and the follow-up is right there, but Kabuki is able to survive, and unfortunately, Rupture is taken out, but Schwan was able to actually dive in the back line and do a lot of damage. So it does seem like with both teams being so aggressive, whoever makes the first move, right, catches the opposing team off guard and gets an inherent advantage. So both teams right now will be looking to be the aggressors, and I think that is why the game is gonna pick up a lot faster now, especially because the Lord is on the table.
The replay was presented to you by the Galaxy A535G, and so is this real-time win probability that actually favors Geek Fam still. Still a 3k gold lead, and look, bottom side Aura! They do not clear the side lanes before they contest this Lord. And admit, this is what Geek Fam should have done with the first Lord. Schwan gets a solo kill?
Yeah, Jamet goes down just like that, and it might be someone else next. Facehugger might be the target, but unfortunately, we'll still be able to be defended by Fluffy as well as Godiva for now. But, oh my god, Jamet, poor guy, man.
Oh man, yeah, I mean, Jamet got collapsed on, but that was amazing macro from Geek Fam, and a little mistake from Aura. I can't believe they let that happen in the bottom side.
Wow, it's just a very, very critical oversight from Aura right now. As we take a look at the items, Hans is 5-0-2, and that item build is obnoxious. It annoys me just looking at it. So much damage, at the same time, so much sustainability. That is the name of the game right now. And Schwan, early since the beginning of the game, doing a lot of damage. If he gets a very critical wild charge onto more than three people, I think that is just instantly the fight kind of won by Geek Fam. Vince also has a genius one, by the way, so he does have a lot more of an aggressive build. It's only a matter of if he can get someone alone and do that burst damage.
Yeah, for sure. We'll see what they can do with this, as the Lord is just disappeared. I mean, wow, Geek Fam weren't able to get any objectives on the board with that Lord, aside from almost a tower. But other than that, Aura Fire is still able to defend that one.
Remember what we said in game one? No siege. Game two as well in the draft, no siege. Geek fam have no siege, no ranged heroes to poke these turrets down. The bottom side turret was at 1 HP and they still couldn't get it down. Why? No wave clear, no high ground potential, and this is going to be their curse. If they can't end the game in the next 2 minutes, 3 minutes, Aura will take over.
Well, I think if they can execute the fights properly, right, they have a chance to just dive under the turret, and if they can get enough of an advantage in a fight, the lack of high ground, the lack of siege really won't matter if you're not sieging, right, if you're just fighting. So that will be what GFM needs to find, and with 70 seconds on the next Lord, I think they have to actually try and get something at the right time, right? Because if they can't pick up now, it really won't matter just yet. They have to make sure it's timed perfectly.
Both teams are just freezing up the waves right now, Rashi, but I feel like it's just really weird to see Aura Fire having this much pressure on the map, even though they only have three more turrets left. Geek fam, they need to put more pressure onto the map. They need to look and group maybe to go for these pickoffs. Because Fluffy, he's opening up the map like this. If you have four members together, he's a goner.
Right. I think the division of tasks right now, who is going to split push, who is going to stick and make sure that the Lord control is achieved, will be critical. Both teams are now waiting to try and spring a trap because, again, whoever pulls the trigger and makes the first engage will most likely get the advantage in tempo in the fight, and that is what both teams really are trying to contest. Although in the bot side right now, GeekFam seems to be the one proactively getting the control in the Lord side.
This is where they struggle, though. Do you see how slow Matilda is clearing out the waves? He has no wave clear. It has to be Hans, it has to be the Grok, or even Renvi on the Dairoth to clear off these waves. And the thing is, when you have that mid laner, you expect the mid laner to be able to clear. Vince has this task, but so far, he hasn't been able to clear the waves fast enough, and Fluffy will be able to open this up.
Yeah, and even topside is pushing here as Fluffy, although he is tanky, he can't sustain that much damage, but he actually is still surviving. The flicker does come into play here as well as that Immortal. As now, Jamet, what will he be able to do with this? The hard guard does open up onto him, but he's a bit stuck behind that wall. Schwan is able to get away. Facehugger goes down, though, in the bottom side. So a man advantage from the side of Geek Fam being able to take Facehugger, but what will they be doing for this? Are they going to push for the Lord even though the top side is pushing?
I think it favors Aura Fire again because of that macro play they did in the top side, clearing it first. Renvi ignored it completely. Now it's gonna be a 4v3 in the Lord pit. Renvi is forced to micromanage the wave up top. And wait, Rupture, what are you doing?
Oh no, Rupture goes in for something, but it actually misses. Jamet might be able to punish him from this. He does flicker into it, and the Immortal pops. Will he be taken down instantly with that? As a mega kill has been secured by the side of the Balmon, and Hans will be the next one to fall. A shutdown has been taken into the hands of Aura Fire, and they are free to get this Lord.
Can we hear it again? It's macro plays. You don't go for the Lord when you don't have this side lane pressure. It just doesn't work like that. You can just keep on playing the long game. That's what Aura did. They had the top side pushing. This is an uncontested Lord. They're just baiting for fights. And if Geek Fam don't commit onto this, it's a free Lord. It's a forced error from Aura.
Yeah, now Schwan is caught in a bad situation here. The real world manipulation gets opened up, but luckily the guiding wind comes into clutch. Aura Fire able to get that Lord, able to get a kill onto Diroth, and that's one member down, a Lord on the way, and it might be disastrous for Geek Fam at this stage.
Quote me again on this, if they don't end within the next 2 or 3 minutes, I said that during the 14 minute mark, guess what time it is? It's 7:37 in of the game. I think Aura have just gone it.
Well, we'll just have to see, man. Right now, Facehugger will be the main siege tool for Aura Fire. They have a lot more options, but Geek Fam, if they can get a good fight, if they can get a great pickoff, they can still take this home. But that will be very difficult because if you can see the positioning coming in from Aura, they have been on the opposite end before. They know exactly what Geek Fam is trying to do. And Fluffy investigates and finds the members of Geek Fam, pushes them back into the base, and it will be a siege situation.
Yeah, he might just be able to, I don't know, bait some resources, but not just yet, as, oh my god, the damage. Fluffy is actually caught in a weird situation here, will be ejected, but the Winter Truncheon comes into clutch for him, as the Heart Guard will be able to support him as well.
Renvi!
Look at the damage he has onto Vince. Renvi, caught in a weird situation in the backside, is able to zone them away, but now, what is Aura Fire going to do? They need to be able to pick someone off for now, but it seems like they will be focusing on the objectives in that turret, whoa, in the bottom side, in the back side. But look at this. Fluffy goes so aggressively into that backside. Fluffy goes down. Rupture goes down too. A trade has happened here as Vince is going to be taken down in a double kill. Renvi might be next, or maybe Shuan. The Jamet is the Angela goes clutch here, Mirko.
Absolutely. Hans is trying to defend here. Jamet jumping in with a knockout strike. Hans, Winter's Truncheon.
Winter Truncheon is going to be there. We'll be able to buy some time. But will it be enough? 3v1 situation, the real world manipulation as well. But the answer is no. Ultimately, Geek Fam will fall deeper into the abyss. That is the eighth standing.
Oh man, not a single game victory once again. Aura, one step closer to getting that upper bracket position. Arashi, did you see what